गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ त्रिवेणी मेमोरियल सीनियर सेकेंडरी स्कूल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट योर न्यू चैप्टर। इट विल बी लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी बुक। नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज वेस्ट वाटर स्टोरी। इन द प्रीवियस टू प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू द वाटर एंड द अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर प्रेजेंट ऑन द अर्थ। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ द वाटर विच इज ऑलरेडी वेस्टेड और पोल्यूटेड, हाउ वी क्लीन दैट वाटर। ओके, वी विल लर्न अबाउट द स्टोरी ऑफ क्लीनिंग ऑफ दैट पोल्यूटेड वाटर इन दिस चैप्टर। सो लेट अस बिगिन दिस चैप्टर। ऑल ऑफ अस यूज वाटर इन अवर होम्स एंड मेक इट डर्टी। ओके, वी कैन नॉट डिनाई दिस। यस, वी मेक वाटर डर्टी एंड वी पोल्यूट वाटर डर्टी। आर यू सरप्राइज? रिच इन लेदर मिक्सड विद ऑयल ब्लैक ब्राउन वाटर दैट गोज डाउन टू द ड्रेन फ्रॉम योर सिंक, फ्रॉम द शावर, फ्रॉम टॉयलेट लॉन्ड्रीज इज डर्टी। ऑल दैट वाटर इज डर्टी। वी कैन नॉट कंज्यूम दैट वाटर, सो इट इज डर्टी। ओके, इट इज कॉल्ड वेस्ट वाटर। ऑल द वाटर दैट इज रिलीज फ्रॉम ऑल दो सोर्सेज इज वेस्ट वाटर। This used water should not be wasted. We must clean it up by removing the pollutant. So we need to remove all those pollutant and we should clean that water, because as we know that otherwise we will face water scarcity. Okay, we must clean it up by removing pollutant. Have you ever thought where the wastewater goes and what happened to it? In this chapter we are going to learn about what happened to the waste water. Okay, so water, our lifeline. Need not to say anything more than this. We have discussed about that thing in our chapter 16 also. Clean water is a basic need for human being. Let us make a mind map of the many uses of the clean water. So you can write down the uses of the clean water in this activity 18.1. Okay. Now, clean water that is fit for use is unfortunately not available to all of us. We know that water is available. Water is everywhere. Our planet Earth is 70% water. Still, we face this problem of water shortage because the water which is available is just 1% of that entire water. So that's why we need to conserve the water. It has been reported that more than 1 billion of the our fellow human beings have no access to the safe drinking water. This accounts for large number of water related diseases such as diarrhea, cholera. Okay, this accounts for large number of water related diseases and even death also in many parts of Africa, in India also. Okay, women and girls walk for several kilometers to collect clean water, as you read in chapter 16. Okay, that's why they are not able to get the education which you are getting, because they have to fetch water from a long distance. Okay, from their home. So is it not a serious matter for human dignity? It is. So we must think about this thing. You have studied in chapter 16 about the increasing scarcity of fresh water due to population growth. So population growth is one of the major factor for this problem, water related problem. Okay, industrial development, then mismanagement and other factors. Realizing the urgency of situation on the World Water Day on 22nd March, as we have discussed, 22nd March is your water day. Okay, to aware people regarding all these issues related to water shortage problem. The General Assembly of United Nations proclaimed the period 2005 to 2015 as the international decade means 10 years. Okay, for the action of water for life. All the efforts made during this decade aim to reduce by half the number of people who do not have access of this safe drinking water. Okay, cleaning of water is a process of removing the pollutant before it enter in the water body so that we can reuse it. Removing the pollutant so can we reuse that water which is now dirty is the waste water management. Okay, the process of waste water treatment is commonly known as sewage treatment. So what is sewage? The water which is now dirty is considered as sewage, which is containing pollutant. ओके, इट टेक प्लेस इन सेवरल स्टेजेस, इट्स नॉट अ वन स्टेज प्रोसेस, इट इज डन इन मेनी स्टेजेस. So, what is sewage? Sewage, you should know the definition of sewage. This is the first most important question of this chapter. Sewage is wastewater released by home, industries, hospitals, then offices and other users. The wastewater which is released from all those sources is known as sewage. Okay? It is also including rainwater that ran away in the street during the storm or heavy rain, as we have discussed. Otherwise, rainwater is the purest form of the water, but the moment it reached to the ground level, it contained many pollutants, and now that water is also considered as a sewage water. The water that washes off on the road and rooftop carry harmful substances with it, so it is not a pure water now. Sewage is a liquid waste. Okay, it's not a solid waste. Solid waste is garbage. Sewage is a liquid waste. Okay, most of it is water which is dissolved and containing suspended impurities. These impurities are also known as contaminants. Okay, now let us read activity 18.2. Locate an open drain near your home, school or the roadside and inspect the water flowing through it. Record color, odor and any other observation. Discuss it with your friend and your teacher. Okay, now we know that sewage is a complex mixture containing suspended, solid, organic and inorganic impurities. Okay, it also contains saprophytic and disease causing bacteria with it, because they are present everywhere, and other microbes. What are the organic impurities in that sewage? It include human excreta, human feces, okay, animal waste, oil and urea from your urine, okay, urine from all the animals also. All these things are known as organic impurities because they are that removed from the that living thing. All the impurities of the living thing can be considered as organic impurities, okay. And what are the inorganic and other organic impurities also containing? Pesticide, herbicide, fruit and vegetable waste, because these are also made from any living thing. What are the inorganic impurities? It consists of nitrate, phosphate and metals. All the harmful chemicals, all the harmful material in the nature consist of inorganic impurities, non-living impurities. Now nutrient, what are the nutrient? Phosphorus and nitrogen. Other than that, many other nutrients are also present in the waste water. Then bacteria which causes cholera, typhoid, etc. Next is other microbes which can cause dysentery. Microbes are present, many bacteria are present, even viruses are present, pathogens are present. So that's why we should not consume that water. Okay, sometime it will be lethal also. Person may die also if that person consume that water without the treatment. That's why we need to treat that water. Okay, water freshen up. An eventful journey in the home. So let us now unfold the journey of that wastewater from our homes. Okay, in a home or a public building, generally one setup of pipe bring clean water and another setup of pipe take away the wastewater. As you know, the clean water came in your house through a tap, okay, and it also that get away from your home from one pipe only. Okay, imagine that we could see through the ground. We would see network of big and small pipes interconnected. All that system is known as sewer and forming a sewerage system, okay, that deal with all that wastewater. It is like the transportation system that carries sewage from one point to another point, okay, for the disposal. Okay, like the transports, many transport vehicle carry you from one place to another place. In the same way, this sewer pipe, what it do? It just that transport the sewage or the wastewater from one home, from your home to the point of the treatment. That treatment point is known as treatment plant. In this plant, the water get purified. Okay, manholes are located at every 50 meter to 60 meter in the sewerage at the junction, okay, of two or more sewer at the point where there is a change in the direction. Okay, So now activity 18.3. Study the sewerage route in your home, school or building. Do the following. Make a line diagram which follow your sewage route. Walk down to the street or survey the campus to find out number of manholes present in that particular area. Then follow an open drain and find out where it end and where and which living organism are found in that particular area. Okay. The area in which sewage containing many bacteria are the area in which most children are affected. Okay. Next is, in case you do not have sewerage system at it in your locality, find out how sewage is being disposed of in your area. Okay. Since we are living in a city, so that's why our city has this sewerage system. Now, treatment of polluted water. Perform the following activity. It will help you to understand the process that take place at the wastewater treatment plant. Let us study this activity 18.4. Divide yourself into group to perform the activity. Record observation of each stage. Fill a large glass 3/4 full of water. Add some dirty organic matter such as grass pieces, organic peels or small amount of detergent or any thing which came in your mind. Okay. Cap the jar, shake it well, let the mixture stand in the sun for 2 days. Now, after 2 days, shake the mixture and pour the small sample into test tube. Okay. Now, label this test tube before treatment. Sample 1. How does it smell? It will smell foul. Okay. Use an aerator from the aquarium to bubble air through the sample in the glass jar. Okay, there is an aerator present in the aquarium or you can purchase one. Allow several hours to aerate. Leave the aerator attached overnight. If you do not have an aerator, use a mechanical stirrer, okay, or a mixer grinder you can also use in this. You may have to stir it for the several time. You just have to mix it thoroughly, okay. The next day, when the aeration is complete, pour another sample into second test tube and label it after aeration sample 2. Okay. Fold the piece of filter paper to form a cone. Wet the paper with the tap water and then insert the cone in the funnel. Okay. Mount the funnel on a support. As we have learned this thing in class 6 also, the use of filter paper. Place layer of sand, fine gravel and finally a medium gravel in the funnel. Actual filtration plant does not use filter paper obviously. It will use certain other things to purify water. This is just a demo for that thing. Okay. Now, yes. Actual filtration plant does not use filter paper, but the sand filter is several meter deep. Okay, so pour the remaining aerated liquid through the filter into the beaker. Do not allow liquid to spill over because it is harmful. If the filtered liquid is not clean, filter it for few times till you get the clear water. Okay, so this is the demonstration of how this thing happens in actual sewage plant. Now, pour the sample of filtered water into third test tube and label it as filtered sample number 3. Pour another sample of filtered water into fourth test tube. Add a small piece of chlorine tablet. Mix it well until the water is clean. Label the test tube as chlorinated sample 4. Now you will get idea of the steps which are used to clean the water. Okay. Observe carefully the sample in the test tube. Do not taste it. It is still not fit for drinking. Okay. You can just smell it and you will get the idea. Now that water is not smelling foul. Okay. What changes did you observe in the appearance of the liquid after the aeration? You have to answer this question after performing this activity. Did aeration change the odor? Okay. What was removed from the sand filter? Did the chlorine remove the color? Did chlorine have an odor? Was it worse than the wastewater? So you have to perform the activity to answer this question. But still, even after all these stages, you are not allowed to drink that water because still that water is impure for your drinking. Okay, because this is just an demonstrated activity. for just demonstration. Okay, now the actual sewage treatment plant we are going to study in this section 18.4, wastewater treatment plant, in short form WWTP. Okay, treatment of wastewater involves physical, then chemical and biological process. You can divide the entire process into three categories: physical, then chemical, then biological. Okay, so which remove physical impurity, chemical impurity as well as biological matter from the contaminated wastewater, and then only that water will be fit for your drinking. First is, the water is passed through a bar screen, like which is shown in this diagram. I hope you have seen this thing. Okay, now large object like rag, like stick, can, plastic packet and napkins are removed from this bar screen. Okay, then what happened? Then the water goes to the grit and the sand removal tank. The speed of the incoming wastewater is decreased to allow sand, grit and pebble to settle down. Firstly, the whole thing is screened through the bar screen. What is the purpose? So that physical impurities will be removed. Have you seen such bar screen in normal gutter? When you see that bar screen is present over there, so that all the physical impurities will be removed at this stage one only. Then, and the entire water is made to pass through the grit and sand removal tank. Okay, it will further remove some other physical impurities which is still present in the water. Now the water is then allowed to settle in the large tank, which is sloped towards the middle. It will be sloped towards the middle. Solid like fecus matter settle down at the bottom and remove with a scraper. This is known as sludge. Now this part is known as sludge. A skimmer remove the floatable solid like oil and grease. Then the water is allowed to skim, and the skimmer remove the floatable solid, oil and grease. Water so clear is called as clarified water, still unfit for drinking. Okay, at this stage water is called as clarified water. Up to some level, some impurities has been removed, but still this water is not fit for drinking. Now this is known as water clarifier. The sludge is transferred to separate tank where it is decomposed by anaerobic bacteria. The biogas produced in the process can be used for fuel as well as to produce electricity. So even the waste is giving us electricity. So nothing is actually a waste. We are using that waste to produce electricity as well as biogas as a biofuel. Now air is pumped into that clarified water to help aerobic bacteria to grow. Now we want good bacteria to grow in it. But it will do. Bacteria consume human waste, food waste and soap and other unwanted matter still remaining in the clarified water. Still impurities is there. So we make the environment for that aerobic bacteria so that it will grow and it will eat up the waste material. Aerobic bacteria are good, which help us. Okay. After several hours, the suspended microbes settle at the bottom of the tank as the activated sludge. Now the water at the top is to be removed because it is the clean water, still unfit for drinking. Okay, even at this stage water is not fit for drinking. The activated sludge is about 97% of the water. The water is removed by sand drying bed or the machine. Okay, the dried sludge is used as manure. Even at this stage, the waste which we are getting is actually not a waste. It is actually the manure, returning organic material and nutrient to the soil. The treated water has very low level of organic material and suspended matter. It is discharged into sea, river or into ground. Nature clean it up further. Sometime it may be necessary to disinfect that water with chemical like chlorine. Okay, we had to add chlorine and ozone before releasing it to the distribution system. Okay, now this water is fit for drinking for animals. For us, it is still not up to the mark. Still, it has to go to some processes before it came to our houses. Okay, so now, and even if in our houses, we need RO for cleaning this water further. Okay, become an active citizen. Waste generation is a natural part of human activity. Okay, but we can limit the type of waste and quantity of the waste produced. Waste can be divided into two categories, biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Dumping biodegradable waste is not a big deal for us. Okay, the organic bacteria, the aerobic bacteria will eat it up. But what is the main cause of concern for us? It is non-biodegradable waste, because there is no way by which we can dump it. Okay? Often we have been repelled by offensive smell. The sight of open drain is disgusting. The situation worsen in the rainy season when the drains start overflowing. We have to wade through the mud pool or the road. Most unhygienic and unsanitary conditions prevail in this situation. Flies, mosquitoes and other insects breed in that water. You can be enlightened citizen and approach the municipality or the Gram Panchayat. Insist that open drainage should be covered. Okay, you should do this thing at your level. If the sewage of any particular house makes the neighborhood dirty, you should request them to more consider about their health. Okay, so better housekeeping practice, what you can do at your home level. So first thing is, cooking oil and fat should not be thrown out in the dust. Why? Because they can harden and block the pipes. They will hamper all the process. In an open drain, the fat clog and soil pores reduce its effectiveness in the filtering of the water. Okay, so they will not allow the water to purify at the natural that process. Throw oil and fat in the separate dustbin. Okay, next is chemical like paint, solvent, insecticide, motor oil, medicines may kill microbes which are good for us, which are good in a cleaning of the water. So you should not throw them also in the waste water. Okay, use tea leaves, solid food, remain, soft toy, cotton, sanitary towels, etc. in a separate dustbin. They will also reduce the effectiveness of the cleaning. The waste choke the drain. They will not allow free flow of oxygen, and this hamper the degradation process. So keep all these things in your mind. Now, sanitation and the diseases. Poor sanitation and the contaminated drinking water is the cause of large number of diseases. Let us look at our own country. A vast number of people are still suffering from many diseases. Okay, they are without any sewerage facilities. Where do they relieve themselves? A very large fraction of people defecate in the open and dry river bed, right? On railway track, near field, and many are time directly in the water. Untreated human excreta is a health hazard. It's not good. Okay, it may cause water pollution and soil pollution. Both the surface water and the groundwater is getting polluted by it. Okay, groundwater is a source of water, the ultimate source of water basically, right? Tube well, spring, and many river, as you learn in chapter 6. So it becomes the most common route for water. Okay,
so student, that untreated human excreta is a health hazard. It may cause water pollution and soil pollution, and both the surface water and the groundwater get polluted by it. Okay, groundwater is a source of water for well, tube well, spring, and many rivers. Okay, we have learned about this thing in chapter number 16 also. Thus, it became the most common route for waterborne diseases such as cholera, dysentery, etc., which include cholera, typhoid, polio, manganese, hepatitis, and dysentery, etc. Okay, so what is the alternative arrangement for this sewage disposal? The improved sanitization, low cost on-site sewage disposal. Nowadays, organic toilets are being manufactured for the same purpose in many countries. Okay, disposal system are being encouraged. Example, a septic tank, a chemical toilet, nowadays very famous in European countries. Composting pit, septic tank are suitable for place where there is no sewage system. Okay, for example, for hospitals. Okay, for emergency also they are more useful. Okay, in isolated building, cluster of 4 to 5 houses. Suppose a building is at top of the mountain. In such cases, such thing can be used. Some organization offer hygienic on-site human waste disposal technology. Okay, our southern part of our country also use such systems. This toilet do not require scavenging. Okay, so what will happen? Excreta from the toilet seat flow through covered drain into the biogas plant directly. The biogas produced is a source of energy and it can be used for production of electricity also. One more thing which you should study in this chapter, that is vermicomposting of the toilet, okay? So what is this vermicomposting of the toilet? We have discussed about the vermicomposting thing in our class 6 also. So what is this vermicomposting? Vermicomposting basically is a composting with the help of red earthworm, okay? In the presence of red earthworm, when this composting thing, that is degradation of the household waste into the simpler organic matter to form the manure, it is known as vermicomposting. Okay, this thing is also common. So next is sanitization at the public place. So far we have discussed about the sanitization at your home level or at your individual level. Now let us study the sanitization at the public places. Okay, in our country, fairs are organized periodically. A large number of people participate in them. In the same way, railway station, bus depot, airport, hospitals are very busy places, right? Thousands of people visit them daily. Large amount of waste is generated here. It must be disposed of properly, otherwise epidemics could break out. And nowadays we know the significance or the advantage of this sanitization. Okay, government has laid down certain standard of sanitization, but unfortunately they are not strictly enforced. Okay, however, all of us can contribute in maintaining sanitization at public places. At our level we can do the best, because what is the use of that education if you cannot do that at your level? So contribute in the maintaining sanitization at the public place. We should not scatter litter anywhere. If there is no dustbin in the site, we should carry the litter with you until you find the dustbin. Okay, home and throw it in your own dustbin. You should not throw that litter here and there. Now what is the conclusion of this chapter? We have a role to play in keeping our environment clean and healthy. You must realize that it's your responsibility at your level. What you can do in maintaining water resources in healthy state, adopting good sanitization practice should be our way of life. As an agent of change, your individual initiative will make a great difference. Influence other people also at your level, and you have to teach them the use of this sanitization in their life. A lot can be done if the people work together. There is a great power in collective action. Okay, so Mahatma Gandhi once said, no one need to wait for anyone else to adopt the humane and enlightened course of action. With you yourself can achieve that state. Okay, now let us complete the NCERT question answer part also. Very first is cleaning of wastewater is a process of removing sewage, okay, or the dirt or the contaminants. You can write whatever you want to write in this. Wastewater released by our home is called sewage. Dried dash is used as manure sludge. Drain get blocked by fat and oils, okay. What is sewage? It's a liquid waste. Okay, explain why it is harmful to discharge untreated sewage into river and sea. It will kill the organism, all the life forms present in there. Why should oil and fat not to be released in the drain? Because what is the property of oil and fat? The property of oil and fat is they solidify. And by after solidification, they will block the drain. Okay, so this is the reason. Describe the step involving getting clarified water from the wastewater. We have discussed that thing in thorough in our previous section. You can refer to that part of the video. What is sludge? Again, we have discussed about the sludge, the that precipitated thing which we get in one process of cleaning is sludge. Okay, I explained how it is treated. We have just discussed it. Refer to that part of the video. There is no point of repeating it again. Okay, untreated human excreta is a health hazard, explained, because it causes many diseases. Okay, it will make the water, make the river, all the water sources contaminated. It will cause the disease such as dysentery, cholera, etc. Name two chemical used to disinfect water: chlorine and ammonia. Explain the function of bar screen. It helps to remove the physical waste such as polythene bag, etc. Explain the relationship between sanitization and disease. If you follow the proper sanitization methods, you will not get any disease. Okay, so if you will not follow the sanitization, you will be having disease. So simple thing. Okay, outline your role as active citizen in the relationship of the citizen in the sanitization. So this question demands your creative ideas. So you have to write your ideas, your creative thinking, and your answer on your own. Okay, so that's all for now, students. We will meet in our next video. Thank you.